targets, you know, there's some shaky camera shots which we see in Target 1. Then there's a flash of light and a massive explosion and the crackle of bright orange emerges. Can you tell our viewers what we are seeing here, please? Yeah.
Arnab, मेरे ख्याल से reconnaissance की footage है जो पहले इन लोगों ने क्योंकि जो surgical strikes हुई रात को हुई थी तो UAV का जो footage आप देख रहे हैं वो surgical strikes का footage है और दिन का जो footage है ये शायद reconnaissance का है जो रेकी करी थी उन्होंने पहले जो army के लोग गए होंगे intelligence के RNW के लोग गए होंगे जो भी था वहाँ पे this is that reconnaissance photographs they have clearly mapped out the area all the intelligence has been gathered passed behind to our boys and then what you see on the screen right now Arnab those grey images This is your UAV flying at probably 25,000-30,000 feet in the air, capturing every small single detail, and then you see the explosions, Arnab. That is what is happening on screen right now.
Yeah. Yeah, and main abhi main target number two. I'm going to describe target number two now right now, Gaurav. And if you're seeing target number two, this is also well beyond the line of control. We run that footage right now. Target number two is very clear footage actually. Isme you see that there is a footage which seems to be from behind a tree or at a height. This is the UAV footage, of course, which is black and white.
Yes.
And then we see the footage from the mounted camera. Isko zara describe kare, Gaurav. Can you describe this for us?
Arnab, ye mounted camera, obviously, this is in all probability a helmet mounted camera on a soldier. And they have the target in their sights. And yes, you see that flash, Arnab.
Yeah.
This is Happy Diwali. This is Happy Diwali.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Arnab, there it goes. There it goes. Team.
Absolutely.
This is the assault team.
Yeah. Yes, they have gone in and they have started the assault, Arnab.
Yeah.
This is the assault team.
Yeah,
you are showing the surveillance team actions.
Yeah.
This Arnav, this is the assault team.
Yes, I can see
then
that.
Then they carry out the precision strike.
Yes.
From a very close quarter.
Oh,
you have to get nearer to the target.
Yeah.
Carry out the strike.
Huh.
Mop up that area and then get back.
Huh. Yeah. Yeah. Now I look at for target number three. This assault team we are describing, what would be the distance of this assault team really?
Assault team is less than 300 meters. It is, you know, a small arm range.
Yeah.
It is on the small arm range where the assault team carries out a fire assault on the target.
Yeah.
Because they have to ensure that they can see the target well.
Yeah.
And what you can see the objective.
Yeah.
Absolutely clear.
Yeah.
It is from probably their helmet mounted cameras.
Yeah.
You can see the figure.
Yeah.
And figure 11 target is not more than 300 meters.
Amazing.
They are as close to that to the target area.
Yeah. So if I look at target 3, and I think I'm running target 3 footage right now, there is a massive assault which shakes the frame so much that the smoke is eclipsing out. Or I think this is the bit of footage, right? Gaurav, is this the footage? And then the black smoke rises into the air in the aftermath. Then a missile-like weapon fires right through the middle of the frame to hit the center of the target. Can you describe, Hindi mein or English mein, what is happening here, Gaurav and Gaurav? Can you describe this, please?
Arnab, ye jo hai ye, jaise ki abhi General Kulkarni ne bhi bataya, ye pehla wala jo tha, wo Airbus tha. I think in all probability, it's not, footage is not very clear, but they are probably using 84mm Carl Gustav rocket launchers.
Yes.
They would have fired an HE, which is high explosive, ya fir high explosive anti-tank unhone dala hoga andar.
Yeah.
एयरबस से उन्होंने जो खुले में लोग हैं उनको मारा है और जो पक्का टारगेट है जो उनका जो वो स्ट्रक्चर बना है स्ट्रक्चर को उन्होंने डायरेक्ट हिट मारी अंदर जो आप एक्सप्लोजन अपने स्क्रीन में देख रहे हैं दिस इज डेफिनेटली टू माय माइंड डेफिनेटली 84mm कार्ल गुस्टाफ ये रॉकेट लॉन्चर से तोड़ा गया ये
एटीजीएम एंटी टैंक गाइडेड मिसाइल व्हिच इज फायर्ड इन द एयर बाय सेटिंग एट द जीरो And special forces carry 84 RL.
Yeah.
Sometime it is difficult to hit.
Yeah.
That's why, you know, generally 100% precision is this weapon.
Yeah. So if I
and
if
there
I,
are rocket launchers.
Yeah.
Which is ATGM, which can be carried and soldier fired.
Yeah.
And it's quite, you know, special forces have got that.
Yeah. And if I'm looking at target number four. If I look at target number four, this is absolutely direct hit. It's a direct hit. Now, what is happening here out here? You know, and this is probably the first one. But with a lot of confidence, they go in for the first hit and they completely take out seven people out there in that. Gaurav, can you describe it? And I think we have General Kulkarni also. Can you describe what's happening here? They're totally taken by surprise. Like ants, we eliminate each one of them.
Arnab, this looks like an Airbus. Sir, this looks like an Airbus.
Absolute Airbus.
Huh? This is an Airbus.
You can see those men walking. You can spot all of them on the target.
Yeah.
You can see them all dying also. In fact, over there, all lying.
Yeah.
One by one, they've been picked and shot.
Yeah.
And that is how this entire operation,
yeah,
we had almost 40 people who
yeah.
were killed.
Yeah.
38 were all militants.
Wiped
and
clean.
Two of the Park soldiers who
yeah.
died in this operation.
So wiped clean out here, right, General Sinha? We're absolutely wiped clean. You know, you have back-to-back assaults, one after the other. Wiped clean. Complete aggression.
Yeah. Arnav, the beauty of this, with that assault team, there is a surveillance team which goes, you know, well in advance, carry out the surveillance.
Yeah.
And when the assault team gets into the position without wasting time, there is also, you know, in this assault team, there are silencing party, that we call it sentry silencing. That also goes very, very close.
Yeah.
And then they hit with the precision.
Yeah.
And you know, the way it has been picked up, it is not the area weapon.
Yeah.
There are number of weapons which has been used.
Yeah.
Variety of weapon system.
Yeah.
There may be a rocket launcher. There
yeah.
may be an ATGM. There may be under barrel, you know, grain launcher.
Yeah.
There may be a sniping also.
Yeah.
So it is, and then, you know, probably they have carried out the mopping of that area. Mopping
yeah.
is that you physically run over the target area.
Yeah.
And then get away. You don't allow any enemy which is sitting that side that
yeah.
you will be left alone.
Yeah.
And probably the mopping up, and then is the time both surveillance and assault group gets back.
Yeah.
It is a textbook, you know, type of raid across the LOC.
Yeah.
It is a surgical and precise strike.
Arnab, one
yeah.
more thing just to add to what General Sinha said.
Yeah.
In mopping up operations, what I think, and this is my assumption, what is normally done, anybody who was injured there, injured,
yeah.
because everybody wouldn't have been killed,
yeah.
anybody would have been injured would have been mopped up.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You know what happens?
Yeah.
Absolutely kill.
See,
yeah.
in these kind of operations,
yeah.
you kill, whether
well, you know,
anybody is shot dead or otherwise,
I just,
you just extricate yourself.
Once again, in case you're joining this broadcast right
there is
now,
a question of counting of what's happening
in case
to
you're,
anybody.
In case you're joining this broadcast right now, viewers, the visuals we are putting out on the screen are the biggest story of the year, because 1.5 years after the Army DGMO issued a statement saying that the Indian Army conducted surgical strikes at several of these launch pads to preempt infiltration by terrorists, we have the tapes and the real-time footage stamped with minute-to-minute precision, which shows how exactly the Indian Army carried out the attack. What we are revealing today on Republic is the biggest story of the year, because it is the ultimate proof of the decisive action taken by our forces just 10 days after the Udi attack that martyred 19 of our army men. And today this silences every politician, armchair activist and Lutyens media house that had the audacity to doubt the veracity of the 4 targeted attacks that blew up terror havens in Pakistan. As I beam these visuals to you, I wonder what they will be saying. I'm going to be debating this at 9 o'clock, and the only question I will ask at 9 o'clock, and I'll hand it over to our co-anchors to hold it for a few minutes from now. Shivani, you hold it. I'm going to be back in a few minutes. But I'll only say this today, that today what we put out is a visual testament of the fact that our army takes on unlimited liability and irrespective of personal danger and natural instinct, puts the nation first. Nation first, no compromise is also our call tonight. And Shivani, over to you. I'll be